Morning students, in the earlier class we discussed differential equations and its solutions and higher order differential equations and its solutions. So for finding higher order differential equations and its solutions, we solved complementary functions and particular integrals. Okay, so for getting complementary function and particular integral, it is very difficult for the students. Okay, so there is an important tool for finding differential equations in easiest way, that is Laplace transform way. Okay, that means Laplace transforms plays an important role for finding the solution of differential equations by without finding complementary functions and particular integrals. Okay, so Laplace transform means a transformation of one variable to another variable, and it is essential in electrical circuits and circuit analysis and another engineering subjects and science subjects also. Okay, so suppose we are define a function f of t. Okay, so the function f of t must be piecewise continuous function and having exponential order of a. That means piecewise continuous means, suppose f of t is defined by, suppose it is an example, suppose f of t equal to t when 0 less than t less than a less than some 3 and 2 t square, and it is defined by t greater than 3. Okay, so we are defining f of t, okay, when it is equal to t between 0 and 3 and t square and more than t value. Okay, so you can observe t value is always more than 0. Okay, so f of t is piecewise and also continuous, and it also satisfies the condition. Suppose it is an exponential order of a, then limit t tends to infinity e to the power of minus at into f of t must be a finite value. Okay, so as taking limiting t tends to infinity e to the power of minus at f of t equal to some finite value, then f of t is exponential order of a. Okay, so when f of t satisfies piecewise continuous condition and exponential order of a, then the Laplace transform is defined. Okay, so before defining Laplace transform, we need to know integral transformation. So integral transformation means, suppose the integral transformation I of f of t. Okay, so integral transformation of f of t is equal to integral 0 to infinity e to the integral 0 to infinity, okay, k of fashion. Okay, integral transformation is defined by equal to integral a to b k of st into f of t dt. Okay, this k of st is nothing but called kernel, k-e-r-n-e-l, kernel. Okay, kernel. So this kernel, suppose this kernel is k of st equal to e to the power of minus at. Okay, equal to e to the power of minus st, and a equal to 0 and b equal to infinity, then this transformation becomes integral 0 to infinity, okay, e to the power of minus st into f of t into dt. So here you observe s must be greater than 0. Okay, then this integral transformation is defined by Laplace transformation and denoted by L of f of t. Okay, this is the operator of Laplace transform. Capital L is the operator of Laplace transform. Therefore, the Laplace transform of f of t is defined by integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus st f of t dt, okay, where s greater than 0. The function f of t must be a piecewise continuous function and it is exponential order of a. Okay, now we can derive some important formulae using f of t. Okay, so as we know, Laplace transformation f of t equal to integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus st f of t dt for s greater than 0. Okay, so you can take, suppose f of t equal to 1, then Laplace transform f of t is 1 means Laplace transformation of 1 equal to integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus st into 1 into dt. Okay. So integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus st into dt. Okay. So integral of e power minus st is e to the power of minus st by minus st within boundary 0 to infinity. Okay. Since s greater than 0, t greater than 0, st value greater than 0. Okay. So minus st less than 0. So e to the power of minus st is equal to e 1 by e to the power of st. Okay. So this is equal to first one. So as you substitute t equal to infinity. So t equal to infinity. So 1 by e to the power of infinity. So e value is more than 2.7 something. So 2.7 something and t tends to infinity. Okay. So as t tends to infinity, 1 by e to the power of st also tends to infinity. Okay. So 1 by e to the power of st tends to 0. Okay. So as substitution, this is equal to e to the power of minus infinity minus e to the power of 0 whole by minus s. Clear? Okay. So as t tends to infinity, one by e to the power of st tends to 0. So value 1 is 0. 0 minus e power 0 is 1 by s equal to minus s equal to 1 by s. Okay. So Laplace transformation of 1 equal to 1 by s. If f of t equal to t. Okay. Then Laplace transformation of t equal to integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus st. You can place t equal to t. Okay. So t into dt s greater than 0. Okay, using UV formula, okay, by parts, integration by parts, okay. So t into e to the power of minus st by minus s and minus integral of t derivative is 1 and e to the power of minus st by minus s, okay, into dt, okay. So within boundary 0 to infinity, clear. So this is minus t into e to the power of minus st by s. Minus of minus it is plus 1 by s constant. Again e to the power of minus st integration is e to the power of minus st by minus s. Okay. So 0 to infinity. So as we know, as t tends to infinity, e to the power of minus st tends to 0. So first term is 0. Again you rewrite minus t into e to the power of minus st by s plus e to the power of minus st by s square. Okay. 0 to infinity. Okay. So this is equal to, so taking boundary values and t equal to infinity. So e to the power of minus st tends to 0. So first term is 0. Minus. So t into 0. So second term also 0. Next. Minus e to the power of minus st t tends to infinity. First term is 0 minus e to the power of 0 is 1 by s square. Okay. So term 1 is 0. Okay. Minus of minus it is plus 1 by s square. So Laplace transformation of t equal to 1 by s square. Suppose f of t equal to e power at. Okay. Then Laplace transformation of e to the power of at equal to integral 0 to infinity e to the power of minus st into e to the power of at dt for s greater than 0. Okay. So e integral 0 to infinity e to the power of, take minus s common. Okay. Minus s minus a into t dt. Okay. So e to the power of minus s minus a t by minus of s minus a is the integration of e to the power of minus of s minus a t dt. Okay. So within boundary 0 to infinity. As we know, t tends to infinity, okay, s minus a into t also tends to infinity. So e to the power of minus s into t minus a into t tends to 0, because it is greater than 0, so that e to the power of minus t s minus a of t tends to 0. So first term is 0 minus e to the power of 0 something, so 1 by minus of s minus a. Okay, so minus minus get cancelled, it is 1 by s minus a. So therefore Laplace transformation of e to the power of a t equal to 1 by s minus a. If f of t equal to e to the power of minus a t, then Laplace transformation of e to the power of minus a t. So it is e Laplace transformation of plus a t, e to the power of plus a t. Okay, so that is 1 by s minus a. So instead of plus a t, we are placing minus a. So that simply it is 1 by s minus of minus a equal to 1 by s plus a. That means Laplace transformation of e to the power of minus a t equal to 1 by s plus a. To find Laplace transformation of sin a t and Laplace transformation of cos a t. Okay, as we know, e to the power of I theta equal to cos theta plus I sin theta. Clear? Okay, so that we can write e to the power of I into, instead of theta, you write a t. Okay, so equal to cos a t plus I into sin a t. Cos a t into sin a t. Okay, then apply Laplace transform on both sides. Laplace transform on both sides. So Laplace transformation of e to the power of I into a t equal to Laplace transformation of cos a t plus I into Laplace transformation of sin a t. Okay, so rewrite Laplace transformation of cos a t plus I into Laplace transformation of sin a t equal to Laplace transformation of e to the power of I a t. As we know, Laplace transformation of e to the power of a t equal to 1 by s minus a. Okay, so here you can take a equal to I a. So that using this formula, this is equal to 1 by s minus I a. Okay, so to reduce a, you can rationalize. Okay, so this is equal to multiply and divide with s plus ia by s plus ia into s minus ia. So in the denominator, this is a plus b into a minus b formula. So a square minus b square. So it is equal to s plus ia by a plus b, a square plus b square formula. S square plus into a minus b, a square minus b square formula. Okay, so s square minus I a whole square. Okay, so I square equal to minus 1. Okay, so this is equal to s plus I a by s square minus I square value is minus 1, so that minus a square. So minus of minus, it is plus s plus I a by s square plus a square. Okay, you can separate real part and imaginary part. So here the real part is s by s square plus a square, and imaginary part is I into a by s square plus a square. Okay, so this is the value of Laplace transformation of cos a t plus I into Laplace transformation of sin a t. So you can compare real parts and imaginary parts. Okay, compare real and imaginary parts both sides. So we have, what is the real part here? Laplace transformation of cos a t. Okay, so what is the real part there? S by s square plus a square. Next, imaginary part. What is imaginary part? Laplace transformation of sin a t. Okay, so what is the imaginary part of that one? A by S square plus A square. Okay. You always remember whenever you have, we have a cos, the numerator is S. Whenever we have sine, the numerator is A. Okay. So in the denominator, S square plus A square and S square plus A square is common. So Laplace transformation of cos AT equal to S by S square plus A square. Laplace transformation of sine AT equal to A by S square plus A square. To find Laplace transformation of cos HAT and sin HAT. Okay, as we know, cos HAT equal to e to the power of AT plus e to the power of minus AT by 2. Okay, so Laplace transformation on both sides. Apply Laplace transformations on both sides. Okay, we have Laplace transformation of cos HAT equal to 1 by 2 into Laplace transformation of e power AT plus Laplace transformation of e to the power of minus AT. Okay, so 1 by 2 into, as we know, Laplace transformation of e power AT value is 1 by s minus e plus e power minus AT Laplace transformation is 1 by s plus e. Okay, so 1 by 2 into s plus a plus s minus a by a minus b into a plus b formula. Again, it is s square minus a square. Okay, plus a minus a get cancelled. So 1 by 2 into 2s by s square minus a square. Again, 2 get cancelled. S by s square minus a square. Okay. So Laplace transformation of cos HAT equal to S by S square minus A square. Sine HAT equal to E to the power of AT minus E power minus AT by 2. Similarly, we can apply Laplace transformation, okay, on both sides. So we have L of sine HAT equal to, using linear property, so 1 by 2 into L of e power AT minus L of e power minus AT. Okay, so this is equal to 1 by 2 into 1 by S plus A minus 1 by S minus A, and it is minus 1 by S plus A. Okay, so 1 by 2 into S plus A minus S minus or minus plus A by 2A plus denominator lo A minus B into A plus B. So S square minus A square. Okay. So here S, S get cancelled. And 1 by 2 into, so 2 times A by S square minus A square. Again 2 get cancelled, equal to A by S square minus A square. Okay. This is Laplace transformation of sine HAT. Okay. You remember cos HAT, it is S by S square minus A square. So sin HAT equal to constant A by S square minus A square. Okay. Suppose we have trigonometric function cos, it is S by S square plus A square. It is the sin A by S square minus S square plus A square. Okay. You remember like that.